Okay, so now we will discuss about the evolution of HR. How the HR evolve in the form of waves. There is also an article I have uploaded in the resource section so that it might help you to have a clear understanding of the HR waves. Are we there yet? That is the name of the article. Go and check it out. Evolution of HR in waves. Wave 1 is the reflection of personnel focus on terms and conditions of work, the delivery of HR services and regulatory compliance. It does not focus on other contribution, for example, training and development, auditing employees, employee satisfaction and engagement, supporting talent. Wave 2 is emphasize the design of innovation HR. It's more like an innovative HR. Practices in sourcing, compensation or rewards, learning, etc. Wave 3 focus on the connection of individual and integrated HR practices with business through strategic HR. The concept of strategic HR reflection on the wave 3. It's more like a reflection of strategy with towards an HR alignment. How the HR goals are related towards an strategy of the organization. That's the biggest goal of the organization, to align those strategies with the goals of the practices of HR. Wave 4 is use HR practices to derive a response to external business condition. HR from outside in. What does that mean? HR practices are implementing the change of the environment so that they can have a competitive edge for their organization also. Like, they are not lagging behind of the other competitors. They are reflecting the external environment inside, so they know how to forecast what are the changes going to be implemented, what are the policies they have to be make. These are the relation towards the context in, from outside the in. That is leading towards HR from with outside the in. Also, there are different HR competencies reflected on the article. You can also read those out. That will help you, because HR roles are changing rapidly in line with the changing environment, particularly in the global context. So you would have a clear understanding. So how competencies are required and what competencies you should have in the future. You can also practice those in this period of time. HR professionals need to be constantly aware of the changes in the environment and review their HR practices continuously and not rely on past. What they had designed a few years ago will remain as good today. You have to be, you know, they have to vary and they have to be rapidly changed towards an environment, because our environment is changing continuously. What people have to know and be able to do, knowledge and skills to carry out their roles effectively. The HR professionals should know these things. HR professionals are required to become active players and partners of business and develop human abilities and organization capabilities that enable an organization to compete in the now and in the future. So I guess we have been discussed about the HR a lot. So I think we should have a more of like a soft environment and a ease of to our brains instead of going HR and HR and all that. So I have a question for you. What is the longest word in the English language? You can guess, have suggestions, have. So okay, I'm going to answer. The word is smile, because it's right in the middle of the word mile. So keep smiling, you are doing great. And I will see you in the next lecture. Thank you.